Even though we're now getting pretty familiar with Excel tables and subtotals through the last couple of videos, it's still difficult to analyze large amounts of data. For instance, if we go back to our complete table import on our first tab, we have almost 2,000 customers here. We can use our existing knowledge to analyze it to some extent, like if we wanted to know our top group of customers, we can sort by the total sales column here, or the number of orders, depending on which is more important to us. But this is kind of a pain, and it's hard to analyze from a number of different perspectives. What all can this data tell us? Sometimes we don't even know what our different analysis might reveal, and we want to dynamically do a number of different analyses without working with all of the 2,000 rows at the same time. Actually, in the real world, you might be working with 2 million rows out here, so working with that much data is even more awkward. Just about any time that I'm analyzing more than a couple of dozen rows, I'll use an incredibly powerful tool that's been around in Excel since the early 90s called a pivot table report, or I refer to it just as a pivot table. A pivot table is an interactive tool that easily allows us to analyze and summarize data. We can use it to summarize the data in a table or data from an external data source such as a database. The great thing about a pivot table is that its structure is dynamic and very easy to manipulate or change. Let's see what I mean by that. In order to get started on analyzing our data, we need to create a pivot table out of whatever data we want to analyze. If our data is already in an Excel table like this, I just have to have my cursor in any cell of the table and then go up to Insert. We could let Excel guess at what it thinks is interesting in our data, but I have yet to be pleased with its best guess, so I'll create a blank one by clicking on the pivot table here. Excel automatically selects the entire table and wants to create the pivot table on a new sheet, which is what I usually prefer, so I'll click on OK, and we get this bizarre looking screen. Over here on the left is where our pivot table or pivot table report will render our answer, and it will dynamically change as we alter the fields over here that we want to analyze on this right part of the page. Notice that for each of our columns in our table, we now have a listing of them here. Down on the bottom part of this section, we have areas where we can drag our fields into to filter the data, or we can summarize the data as rows by dragging them here, or as columns if we drag them into this area. Any value that we want to perform mathematical summarizations on, such as adding, counting, min, max, etc., go down here in the values section. Please note that this menu over here on the right and these ribbon menus up here at the top are only visible when I have my cursor inside the pivot table. If I move it out of here into the general area of the spreadsheet, they all go away, so don't do that. To add values to the report, you can check the box. To add values to the report, you can check the checkbox in front of the field, and Excel will try to guess where you want it, but I prefer to drag it explicitly where I want it, so let me start off by dragging state to the rows area. We now see that there are 5 different states represented in our 1993 rows of data. If we want to see the total sales for each of these 5 different states individually, all I now have to do is drag total sales down to the value areas, and voila! Note that it automatically names the field as sum of total sales. You need to keep an eye on this, as Excel will look at the data that you're trying to summarize and may sometimes pick a different aggregation, such as count, min, max, or some other crazy thing. As I always say, though, it's better to be lucky than good, so we'll continue on and be thankful that Excel guessed the right one for us. Now, I've used the term dynamic a couple of times in the last couple of minutes, and here's an example of what I mean by that word. If I would prefer to see this sales summary in column format, then I can just drag the state field over here to columns, and there you go. The report redraws itself. I'll move it back to rows, and now I can add the city underneath the state field, and now we see that for each state, we have the city grouped underneath it, and now we can see our sales by state and by city. If we don't need to look at the city for the moment, we can click on the little minus icon, and all the cities collapse underneath that state. I can collapse them all by right-clicking on it, and then collapse entire field, and it's back to a nice and tidy summarization. Experimenting with our different fields is sometimes useful to see if there's anything useful buried in that field. For instance, if I add phone number, let's see what that gives us. Not much unless I know all of these phone numbers by heart, so I need to delete it. There are a number of ways to remove these fields, such as click on this arrow and select Remove Field, or you can just drag it out of here, and it's gone as well. If we want a different summarization other than sum of total sales, maybe we want the average sales amount for our customers in every state and or city. Then I can do that by going down to that field and selecting the drop-down arrow, then Value Field Settings, and then selecting Average from this list. I can also edit the formatting here, so let me add commas to our numbers while I'm here. I can also change the name of it while I'm here to Average Sales, so I'll go ahead and do that. Now that I've got the average customer sale, I want to also show the total sale again, so I can add it back in, and now I, in essence, have two versions of total sale in the pivot table, the average total sale and the sum per state or city. I can also easily add the number of orders to our report as well by dragging it down here in order to show several aspects of our customer base. I don't have to rerun a query or reconfigure anything to make all this magic happen. Also, notice that our column headers dynamically change to their proper values as I edit our pivot table. Let me show you a few other cool features about pivot tables. I'll simplify this pivot table back to our just sum of sales here. Now let's say we want to get this report of how many customers are in each city within a state. In order to provide this answer, I'll drag the state field up to the filter area of the menu here, and notice that I now have this new area up here in my pivot table that lists all of our states in our underlying data if I click on this drop-down arrow. So here are my five states again. I can now select one of those states by selecting one of these, or if I want multiple states included in my table, then I can just check this box here, and then I'm able to select any combination of states to filter my results on. I'll just do California for now. Next, I want to include company names for a minute just to check things out. I want to determine how many customers are in each city, so I could just count them up manually, but alas, life is too short for that. I remember that there was the count aggregation available to me if I dragged the customer name field into the values menu, and luckily, Excel is smart enough to know that the fields containing just text data, like company name, about the only thing it can do with them is count them, so it does that and all is well. Well, almost. I still want to see the cities with the largest number of customers in them, so I need to sort this column so I can select the value in that column and then go up to this menu and click on the sort icon here for largest to smallest, and now we get the data represented the way we want. Another useful feature of pivot tables is what are referred to as pivot charts. They are also incredibly useful in providing a way to quickly visualize our data and see if there are any interesting patterns in the data that are revealed. To make a pivot chart that is intimately tied to the data in this pivot table, all we have to do is select any cell in the pivot table, then go up to the Analyze ribbon, and select Pivot Chart. We then see all the chart types that we learned about back in Lesson 3 recently. I'll select this first column chart here, and here's what we get. To make this chart more visible, I could move it to its own page by going up here and selecting Move Chart, and then click on this radio button to get it into its own sheet, but I think that for demonstration purposes, I'll just move it over here out of the way and enlarge it a bit. A big difference between this pivot chart and the type of charts that we learned about in Lesson 3 is that with a pivot chart, you can edit how the chart is configured on this page, and it will automatically update how the data is presented back in your pivot table, like this. See how the data changes as I alter the chart? Or vice versa, you can edit the configuration of your pivot table, and the pivot chart will automatically redraw itself to remain in sync with the pivot table. Let me alter this chart a bit so that it shows me the sum of sales for each of our five states. Let me first remove the state from the filter section and drag it back down to the rows section. Since the chart renders exactly what is currently displayed in our pivot table, if the cities are visible in the table, than they are as well in the chart, and it's quickly so convoluted that it's impossible to read or get any valuable insight out of. In order to delete the cities from the chart, I can either collapse all of the cities like this, or I can just delete the city completely from the report, which is what I think that I want to do, because I don't want to confuse the reader with any extra choices. Now I can see in our chart the total sales by state. As you've hopefully seen from this video, pivot tables and pivot charts are a very powerful addition to Excel. Professionals have been using them for about 20 years now to leverage this analytical power in Excel and aid in their decision making. They're incredibly useful as they allow us to quickly analyze data sets of just about any size from a variety of different aspects in order to find the gems that could be buried in our data. Well, that's it for now. In our next video, we'll build on our knowledge of pivot tables and show you even more functionality available to us. Go Noles!